Hi everyone, I'm Snehal Pradhan, former international cricketer and sports journalist, and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about the new and updated rules that the ICC has put into force from the 28th of September 2017. Make sure you're subscribed to my channel so you'll get lots of cricket tips and tutorials in Hindi as well as English. Now there are four major rules that the ICC has changed. The first one is the bat size. For a long time we've seen balls flying off the edges, miss hits going for sixes, bowlers not getting value for the deliveries. The ICC is trying to put that right, and they have said that the edge of a bat can no longer be wider than 40 millimeters, and the depth of the bat, that is the thickest part, can no longer be deeper than 67 millimeters, which means that out of the current crop of players, the likes of Chris Gayle and David Warner will no longer be able to use the bats that they have been using currently, and they will have to switch into the new regulations. The second rule has to do with runouts and stumpings. It says that if the batter grounds the bat across the crease, but then it lifts up in the process of returning back to the crease, the batter will still be given not out, which is currently given out. It's a big relief for a lot of batters. Inadvertently, they dive and the bat comes up in the air a little bit. Those decisions will no longer be given out. Now, the next rule change has to do with DRS. The first thing it says is that DRS is coming to T20 cricket. We'll probably see it in the IPL as well, but the ICC has confirmed that in international cricket, we will see the DRS in T20 cricket. Within the DRS, if a decision is overturned due to umpire's call, which means it's a very close call and the rules mandate that the decision stays with whatever the on-field umpire has given, then the team will not lose their review. This is a big relief, and that's why it's such a popular decision, because generally we see a lot of good reviews, a lot of close decisions get overturned because of umpire's call and team losing their reviews. This will not happen anymore. On the other hand, because the team is not losing their reviews, in test cricket, where reviews are automatically renewed after the end of 80 overs, that will no longer happen. You will have just two reviews, whether your innings last 90 overs or 160 overs. The next change is more powers to the umpire. Finally, and this is something I'm very happy about, we are seeing umpires being able to enforce discipline on the field. This was usually the purview of the match referee. They would do it after the game. But now, if an umpire feels that things are getting violent, things are getting rough, they can send the players off the field, effectively giving them a red card. For a level 3 offense, this can be just for a few overs, but for a level 4 offense, that player can be removed for the entire match, which means if the batter is batting, he will be given retired out. There are also sanctions against excessive appealing, throwing the ball at another player, intimidating or threatening another player or the umpire on the field, and these range from penalties of 5 runs, which apply pretty much everywhere, to sending a player off for a few overs. Unfortunately, and this is something I'm disappointed with, there is still nothing against sledging. There is no clear guidelines about abuse on the field, which is something that I'm slightly disappointed with. I felt this was an opportunity for the ICC to really clean up the game to an extent. So those are the major new rules. Make sure you hit subscribe down there, hit the bell icon so you'll know whenever I'm posting updates, and stay tuned for more cricket tips and tutorials. I've got a lot of interesting content coming up on the channel. Be positive, keep smiling, and enjoy your cricket.